Welcome to Keysight EDA Chiplet PHY Designer demo. In this demo, I will show you how to set up a Chiplet PHY Designer simulation with a die-to-die interconnect EM model as a channel. We will look at the resulting eye and compare it to the UCIe eye mask. Shown here is the layout of the die-to-die interconnect. This is a standard package designed with UCIe bump map. We will later use the 3D EM simulation result in our chiplet simulation. To set up the chiplet simulation, we will find the Chiplet PHY Designer palette. Let's place a chiplet setup component as well as the chiplet simulation. Double-clicking into the Chiplet PHY setup lets you choose the standard, data rate, and package type you're working with. To use our EM simulation result, we drop the post layout component and configure the component with appropriate input files. Pin names and net names should come across nicely from the EM simulation result. Next, we need to place die number 1 on the schematic. You can select your favorite IBIS model to simulate in the chiplet die component. After setting up the IBIS files and enable the signals you want to simulate, clicking Next brings you to the model selection. All the enabled signals will be here for you. Let's repeat the process for die number 2 on the right-hand side. Select, place, and configure. With Chiplet PHY Designer, making connections is very simple. First, click on the wiring button, then the components. A dialog will pop up for you to connect all 16 nets with one click. This smart connection speeds up the setup time. Now, we need to specify what signals to probe. The chiplet probe is the component for that. In chiplet probe, we can select the signals and the measurements we want to see. Of course, we can also set up the UCIe eye mask and check if we pass the eye mask test. After selecting the signals and measurements, we are ready. We are ready to hit the simulate button. Expecting the eyes to be open, we plot the eye and the mask in the data display. Sure enough, the eye is open. Once we finish the eye simulation, we are halfway to the voltage transfer function. Starting from the previous schematic, I will replace the Chiplet PHY simulator with an AC simulator. Clicking into the Chiplet PHY setup to configure the voltage transfer function. First, we will name a CSV file as part of the VTF setup and click Generate. This VTF setup is automatic and ready for the simulation. The auto-generated batch simulation for VTF is in the top right-hand corner. Because the traces are 5 trace width apart, we expect the crosstalk to be under the limit line. Our expectation was correct. I think the loss line will be above the limit line. Indeed, we passed both limit line tests. UCIe standard specifies the implementation of a forwarded clock. An IBIS AMI model can be used to transmit the forwarded clock. We can plot the waveform of the forwarded clock and the transmitted data. This forwarded clock provides timing information to interpret the transmitted waveform to its digital representation. If you want to explore the design space and generate reports, Chiplet PHY Designer is right for you. In this example, I set up the TX and RX. I'm also sweeping the termination resistance values. In Chiplet Probe, I can configure my resistance value exploration and the report generation. Here are the Design Exploration tab and Report Generation function. After you simulate, you will get a report like this. It captures the simulation setups as well as the eye diagrams. This concludes the demo for Chiplet PHY Designer. Thanks for watching!